Previously, we mastered the basic projection setup, how this lighting technique works in Blender, in cycles to be precise, how to make a projector step by step, how to become familiar with that technique. In this video, we'll use this knowledge to create something like this, a colorful slit of lights traveling through some geometry. You won't necessarily get the same result, I mean the exact same, as it's impossible to arrive at the exact same destination twice when using projectors. But that's not the point, don't let it discourage you. We'll have a lot of Blender fun. Let's open up the blend file from the previous tutorial, in which we have set up this projector spotlight. You can find it in the course resources. Copy it out from the right-click menu and navigate now to the next blend file from the same folder. You can find it all in the resources once again. Swoosh! This is our scene in which we'll be trying out projection in a real-world setting, so to speak. It doesn't matter if your result will be close to what I get or not, that's not the point, our goal is to try making a cinematic shot using projection technique. Before we start, this scene should be rendered in cycles, because this type of projection only works in cycles. The viewport mode should be set accordingly to cycles and directive rendering as well. Alright, here we are, let's paste the projector that we copy it from the projector blend file into this new scene. Right click, paste objects. And right away, you see a vibrant red pattern emanating from this spotlight. I'm gonna make it smaller and aim it right at the recorder or whatever it is. By the way, this amazing model was made by Dolgov. I downloaded it from Sketchfab. It's licensed under Creative Commons license. So you can use it in your free and commercial projects with crediting the author. Alright, with that out of the way, we need to angle our spotlight in a certain way. How should we do it? That is the question. But first, as usual, I'll just go ahead and create a new collection for it. Right click in the outliner, new. And how to call it? Oops, sorry. Projector. And I will place our first projector there. There will be more later, so that's the first one. There it goes, inside the projector_01 collection. Once that's done, I'll head over to the light settings tab and see what can be done with the spot size. Basically, I want to see if the beam can be wider or more focused. Okay. So far so good, I think I'll just stick to 45 degrees for now. As you remember, we ended up using video texture for projection, and we can preview it by holding shift and right clicking on the timeline in various places, or scrubbing through the timeline, I should have said. Then shift and left arrow moves the playhead to frame 1, the beginning of the animation. Okay, now we can move the spotlight with G to grab, and to rotate it, I often change the pivot point mode to 3D cursor. You can do it from here or by pressing dot on the numpad for the pivot point mode menu. Then shift and right click to place the 3D cursor somewhere. Then with the spotlight selected, hit R to rotate it or to orbit it around our 3D cursor. The tricky part of using projection is finding the best looking angle. It's a matter of just taking time, I guess. It's never perfect on the first try, so it is okay if nothing fancy comes out right away. I think, personally, I'm just looking for the nicest projection, if that makes sense. I know that's kind of a dumb way to explain it, but this process does involve a fair amount of chance. Just embrace it. Sometimes I change the pivot point mode back to active element to rotate the light around itself to kind of aim it better. It can be also rotated with the R shortcut. Well, if you absolutely want to nail the exact same position of the spotlight that I ended up using here, which is not important, check the final result blend file that comes along the tutorial. But again, that's not necessary, feel free to roll with what you've got. I like that the projection doesn't fill the entire object now, and just leaves a thin and narrow slit of light as an accent, so I'm gonna be rolling with that. I wanted to show really quickly one fairly useful technique that may come in handy for controlling projection, which is light blocking. Sometimes it happens that you like the part of the projection, if that makes sense, and don't like some other part. Okay, first of all, let me remove the background intensity, as this scene had some background ambience built in. This will help us better see the projector. Okay, so let's say I don't like the background spill, this white blob of colors spilling onto the rear end of the scene. What we can do is add a new collection, call it blocker. It won't work if you don't name it properly. Just kidding. And now we can insert a plane, and that plane will cut some part of the light from the projector. I'm using the Blender's translation shortcuts to nudge the plane into place. It definitely has to be in front of the lamp, that's for sure. I'm not sure I need to mention this detail, but anyway. Then I'm just moving it and looking simultaneously at the viewport to see where it needs to be, so this white blob of colors is gone. It could be fairly tricky, and it definitely takes some time. Well, it should probably block the bottom part of the beam like that. Let's give it a scrub with shift and right click on the timeline. Yeah, this slit of red light is looking really nice when isolated like this. It's a power of projection, getting some such random, but pretty cool results. Awesome. Just rotating it a tiny bit. The pointless adjustments, you know? Tweaking it by 1% or something. Let's call a spade, a blocker. And we are good. The first projection, the projector is done. Now, when we blocked a parasitic spill, although it was a stylistic choice, it looks really enticing, at least to my eye. That's how it looks in motion. And in order to see the animation, I gave our sequence a quick animation render. And it already smells cinema. We have one projector done, that's good, but what if we light up the whole scene with the same video texture, using a few projectors? That should be totally doable. The starting point is to make sure we duplicated the spotlight with Shift D. And what else? Let's give it a new cozy home to live. Double click projector 02. Then new collection for it. Then just click and drag it gently into its new home. I'll go ahead and disable the first one temporarily so we can fully focus on that new one. This time I will adjust the radius of the spotlight to blur the texture like that a little bit. And maybe I will adjust the angle a bit so it covers more surface. As if something like that looks good to me. Going over into Material Editor, I'll experiment with the HDR and SDR strength. I don't think it needs as much range as the first one, so I'm reducing this HDR multiplier. Zero takes it out completely. One would do, as I want it to be kind of like a fill light. Not as punchy as the slit of light of the first projector for sure, just a mild colored fill coming through. It uses this same video texture as source for projection. It should be perfectly in sync with the first one, in other words. It'll be an interesting effect to watch when they work together. Scrubbing the timeline again with shift and right click, just to see how it looks at various frames. The levels, I think, can be even lower. The levels are so low because I see this composition as being ultimately a low-key style, moody shot. straight from darker version of Blade Runner that had a love child with Terminator, after the affair with Doom 3 or something. That kind of dark. Okay, enabling the first projector as well, so they work in tandem. Now let's have a proper look at the animation. Chances are these two lights should look like one, because they are in sync, the footage is synchronized, and I think it looks great. For the third layer of projection, I prepared something a bit different. An area light. Yes, area lights can do projection as well. So what I'll do is disable all the light sources, then right-click there and go New Collection. This time it'll be the area light. A bit different workflow, the same principle though. Light area. This one. Let's press G to move it behind the recorder, R to rotate it so it points into the scene. The placement is gonna be a typical upstage lighting from the background side, which I'm sure you are fairly familiar after watching our YouTube tutorial about it. The point is to get a good looking reflection of that soft light from that source. When I'm doodling with a position like that, I'm just looking for the beauty, I guess. The beauty of the reflection of this light. Gonna give it a proper name. It's our third projector, as we remember. The size, I think... what can we do with it? The reflection was okay, so I'll leave it at that. Even though the mechanics are similar, the material settings will differ a bit, though, compared to spotlight projectors. Back to Material Editor. Use nodes. It is important to tick this checkbox, otherwise it won't work. With the emission shader selected, Ctrl+T will populate the nodes we need. Like that. I'll push this group of nodes to the side to free up some space. Then in the image texture node, I'll search for night. And hopefully it'll point me out to our night highway video MP4 file that we used for the rest of the projectors. Cool. Remember we've set the mode to clip previously? Now it should be something different. Repeat. Then cyclic and auto refresh like before, and let's give it 600 frames. A rather quick setup, as you can see. Now for texture coordinates, and that is important, we should choose not UVs and not normals, but reflection. It won't work without that tweak. What should we do with its power though? Let me see. I will set it really high for the moment to gauge how it looks in the viewport. It doesn't mean it'll be that powerful in the final fix, of course. The angle is nice, I quite like it. I'll keep it, I think. Once again, a few words of encouragement. If your result differs from what you currently see, it is normal. Don't worry about that. All projections are unique and deserve to be loved. The sharpness of the texture can be increased by reducing the size of that light, just like in the other types of projectors. And you can tell it is a pretty interesting effect as well. A bit different, but interesting nonetheless, especially in motion, which we'll see in just a moment. Very good looking stuff. Okay, there is no need for such perfect sharpness. On the contrary, I want to increase the size of that light to make the texture buttery smooth for a nice fall-off and reflection. A nice color, of course. There are a few things worth checking out in the shader of this light. There we go, Shift-A and drop the mix node after the MP4, video texture I mean. I thought we could multiply it by the blue color to cool it down considerably and play with the cold versus warm contrast of colors, as the other projections will use more reds and oranges and that kind of stuff, and this one will have a night shade of blue. Thinking cold versus warm. this type of color grading. Finally, I'll dim it down in the light settings, so it sits at the bottom of the range, offering some softness and some shape as well underneath the punchier light materials. A supporting layer, let's say. To give it a more complete preview, I'll go ahead and fire up the rest of the projectors in the scene. It's a full package now, and yeah, I can tell by moving the playhead on the timeline with shift and right click that it will look gorgeous. What else? When I think of it, the first projector that creates the main slit of light can be made way hotter than it is right now. The scene will have a higher contrast this way, and hopefully the secondary light bounces calculated by cycles will get brighter and more interesting as well. That's all, folks. That's all for projection. We did it. Time to stop tweaking it, the result we've got, time to call it a day. Before we wrap it up, I wanted to share a few rendering tips though. In the render settings, we have a few things to check. For the final render and for the viewport, as soon as we got everything sorted out, I would enable denoising, most likely. It doesn't matter which option you choose, it depends on your GPU, anything is better than none, usually. That is denoising. And then high dynamic range projection, or more precisely, its diffuse and glossy light bounces can carry a lot of noise in cycles. One of the ways to fix it, as I did it here, is to clamp the indirect light and do it harshly. Clamp it to 1. As for now, denoiser makes it fairly hard to see what's going on, so here are the comparisons. Here's no clamping and no denoising. Notice the fireflies. And this is the indirect light clamped to 1. Once again, raw and clamped. I hope the video compression gods are merciful today. Yep, nothing else comes to mind. This is the result I've got. All three lights at play. Reaching out for my coffee, and we are heading into the outro. I hope you enjoyed this lighting tutorial and learned a couple of new Blender tricks. It would be amazing if this tool opened up the new interesting lighting workflows for you. If that's the case, please share your results with us on Mastodon, I don't know, on Twitter if it's still alive, and of course in our Creative Shrimp Discord community and everywhere where you find us. Check the full course on Blender Market, Gumroad and CreativeShrimp.com. My name is Gleb Alexandrov, drink more coffee, and we will change the world of computer graphics together.